The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 4, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 19th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Bhumi Rapanalo Bhayu, Kangamano Buddhideva. अहंकार इति अंग में भिन्ना प्रकृति वस्तुता प्रकृति मीन्स एनर्जी फिजिकल केमिकल लाइट साउंड दीज आर द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड बट दे डू नॉट नो वेयर फ्रॉम दीज मेटीरियल एलिमेंट्स कम. In the Srimad Bhagavatam or in the Vedic literature, it is said that the material energy came out of the breathing of the Supreme Lord Mahavishnu. Jasyaika nishasita kalam athavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha. विष्णु महान सहयजस्य कला विशेषो गोविंद मा विपरीतम तम. द मेटीरियल एनर्जी इज कमिंग थ्रू द ब्रीदिंग ऑफ महाविष्णु हु इज लाइंग डाउन इन द कारण कॉजल ओशन. सो फ्रॉम द ब्रीदिंग देर इज साउंड. From the ether, the sound comes. This is scientific. And from the sound, the air comes, the fire comes, then water comes, then the earth comes. The earth is the last gross element in the material science. Therefore, Krishna says, this earth, Bhumi, Bhumi, earth has come out of water, apa. And where from apa water has come, anala, fire. Where from fire has come, from air. Where the air has come, ether, sky. Where from the ether has come, false ego. Then where from it has come, mind. Where from it has come? Intelligence. And where from it has come? From the soul. This is the scientific study. But they do not know background of the soul. They are thinking there was a chunk and there was something. Perhaps it may be. No definite knowledge. But here you can check the definite knowledge where from these material elements come. This Krishna is the Supreme Soul. So from the Supreme Soul all these material elements have come. Just like your body, where from it has come? It has come from the soul. In the Shastra, it is said, karmana daiva netrena jantur deha upapatti. Jantu means living entity. Janva, jantu. So jantur deha upapatti. There, the atheist theory that combination of matter makes a situation when living symptoms come out. Combination of matter. That is the present chemical theory, chemical evolution. There are so many theories based on Darwin's theory. Chemical evolution. Recently, when I was in Los Angeles, one German scientist came there. He has written one book, Chemical Evolution, and he has got Nobel Prize. Now he's touring for lecturing on his theory. So in the California University, there is our student, Dr. Swaroop Damodar. He is my disciple. He is doctor in chemistry. So, when this German chemist was lecturing, theorizing that life has come from chemical, so he put the question, that suppose if I give you these chemicals, whether you can prepare a life. He answered in the meeting, that I cannot say. That means he is not certain. Still he is theorizing that from chemical life has come. No. From chemical life has not come. From life chemical has come. This is real theory. These things are discussed very broadly in our American centers. So, we stick to the point that life does not come from chemical, but chemical comes from life. So I gave one crude example. Just like a tree, it is also life, because there are different forms of life. 8,400,000 forms of life. So, a tree also, another form of life. One who knows what is the condition of life, pandita, learned, samadarshina, vidya vinaya sampanne, brahmani, gavihastini, suni cheta sapati cha pandita, samadarshina. Pandita who knows what is what? He is samadarshi, equipoised. He knows that the substance with the within the tree, or substance with the dog, or substance with the human being, or substance within the Brahmin, or a Sudra, or a dog, or a Chandala, the soul is the same. Therefore, he sees everyone samadarshina. Pandita samadarshina. He does not distinguish between man and animal or tree, because he knows that the living force is the same. Spiritual quality, that is the fragmental portion of the Supreme Soul, Krishna. So we can understand, if we are little sober, how material things come out. Now, we understand from Shastra that after sex between man and woman, the matter is emulsified and creates a situation wherein the living entity takes shelter. Karmana daiva netrem. So, living entity, every one of us, dehantaram prapti, we shall get another body. So, what kind of body we shall get, that is karmana daiva netrem. That will be judged by higher authorities according to our karma. If we have done work like human being, then further promotion will be given. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattva svā madhye tiṣṭhanti rājasā Jaghanna Ginavuttissa Adhogacchanti Tamasa. There are three qualities of the material nature. One who is associating with the modes of goodness, they are being promoted to the higher planetary system. Those who are associating with the modes of passion, they will remain within this middle planetary system. And jaghanna gunavittistha, those who are most abominable, acting most abominable, jaghanna guna adhogacchanti, this is confirmation. Adhogacchanti goes down to the animal kingdom, to the beasts, birds, reptiles, snakes, so many things. There are 8 million forms. It is daivena, daiva netrena. Netrena means by supervision. Background of the supervision is Krishna. Mayadhakshena prakriti suyati ca saracharam. Absolutely. In the Bhagavad Gita, in another place it is said that upodrashta anumanta, the super soul, soul and super soul, there are two souls, the supreme soul and the subordinate soul within the body. So, what we are doing, subordinate soul, the supreme soul or the super soul, who is also sitting with me within the heart, he is upadrashta anumanta. He is simply seeing. And anumanta means without his sanction, we cannot do anything. Sarvasya chaham nidhisannivishta. Everyone has got experience. When you want to do something wrong, there is conscience. Don't do it. No, let me do. There is struggle. So this is the struggle between the soul and the super soul. But when you are persistent that I must do it, then the super soul orders, all right, you can do at your own risk. That is called karma phal. We have become subjected to the resultant action of our karma. That is called karmana. By the activities, daivanetrena, by the superior authorities, superintendents, daivanetrena, jantar dehavapatti, the living entity gets a type of body. What is this body? The five elements, bhumi, rapa, anara, vayu, kama, mana, buddhi, reva, 8 elements. Earth, water, fire, air, and sky, the mind, intelligence, and ego. Ego, false ego. The false ego is that I am this body. Ahankar. I am American. I am Indian. I am Hindu. I am Muslim. These are all false ahankar. Neither I am Hindu, nor Muslim, nor Christian, nor American, nor Indian. I am living entity. Mumaimansa jiva bhuta jiva loke sanatana manasasthani indriyani prakitisthani karsati. Krishna says that all these living entities, they are my part and parcel. But they are struggling hard against these material laws. Mana sasthani indriyani prakitisthani karsati. By mental concoction, he is creating a situation and he is getting that type of body. Otherwise, why there are so many varieties of bodies? These are the creation of our mental concoction. I shall do that, I shall do that, I shall do this, I shall do this. So, this is daivanetrena, he gets. Daivanetrena by superior. He gets like a child. insist upon doing something, the father says, all I do it. I don't. He says, don't do it, but he persists, I must do. All right, do it. There are many examples. There is soul, and there is the gross material body, and there is the subtle material body. The soul is the basic principle. To get a body, as I have already explained, the secretion discharged by the father and the mother, they mix up, they are emulsified and forms in the body of a pea. And the soul comes through the seminal, the father, and is situated there. Then the body develops. Now, just try to understand, because the spirit soul is there, therefore matter is developed. If the soul is not there, if the child is dead, no more development. No more development. No dead child develops body. Everyone knows. Therefore, these material elements come from the spirit soul. Not that spirit soul comes from the material element. This is wrong theory. If it comes from the material combination, then why can you produce a living entity in the laboratory? No, that is not. A material, because material creation is there, because I wanted such a circumstances, atmosphere. And Anubhanta, the Supreme Lord, He is the Supreme Sanction Giver. He gives me opportunity to enter into certain type of mother's body and the material grows. So the actual fact is, from spirit soul, the energy, material energy comes out. Take for example that I was giving. The chemicals. Now take one lemon tree. It is a living entity. And it is producing, at least, hundreds of pounds of citric acid. Lemon. Everyone knows. You take 50 lemons today, again take 50 lemons, and if you extract the lemon, you'll find extensive quantity of citric acid. So where from the citric acid chemical comes? Because the living entity is there in the tree. Therefore the conclusion should be, the chemicals come from life. Life does not come from chemical. If life comes from chemical, then you produce. I give you the chemicals, whatever chemicals you want. So chemical is produced. Just like you have got experience when there is perspiration. We taste the perspiration, there is salt. Where from the salt comes? Salt is, what is the chemical name? Sodium carbonate, no? Sodium chloride. So sodium chloride, where from it comes? It comes from your body. And your body comes from the soul. Therefore, the original cause of sodium chloride is the soul. So as you can analyze, a little quantity of chemicals from your body, from tree's body, from anybody, so you just imagine the unlimited body, gigantic body of Krishna, Virat Purusha, how much chemicals it can produce. Therefore, don't take it that this is all imagination. Krishna says, bhumirapanalobayokhangamanobuddhirivacharahankarvithiyangme bhinna prakriti astadha. these eight kinds of materials, gross and subtle, they are my energy. It is coming from Krishna. Krishna is not talking any nonsense, he is not bluffing you. At least those who are advanced, why you are reading Bhagavad Gita? Because it is authoritative. Krishna is speaking. That is fact. The most exalted authority. We have to take knowledge from the authority. We cannot manufacture knowledge. That is imperfect knowledge. Because our senses are imperfect. We have got four deficiencies. We commit mistake. We become illusioned. We commit mistake, everyone knows. I have several times talked that even a personality like Gandhi, he committed so many mistakes. So long you are conditioned by the material nature, you must commit mistake. There is no escape. Similarly, we are illusion. Illusion means we accept something for something. That you are accepting this body. I am American, I am Indian. But I am neither American nor Indian. I am spirit soul. This is called illusion. Brahm Pramad. Vipralipsa. Vipralipsa. Means the propensity for cheating others. I do not know exactly what is the cause of life. Still, I am theorizing in so many ways. And when I am challenged by another person, can you produce with chemical life? That I cannot say. Then why are you talking nonsense? This is cheating. If you are actually in knowledge that from chemical life can be produced, then you produce it. I give you chemicals. But when you cannot do, why you are cheating people? But this cheating propensity is there. One is a nonsense number one, but he speaks. They will cite scripture. That we do not accept. Our Krishna consciousness movement does not accept the scripture cited by the Devi. Therefore we have accepted Krishna. Sarva karana karana. Whatever he says, we accept. We are not perfect. Our senses are not perfect. We are fool number one. But the knowledge which we accept, that is perfect. That is Krishna consciousness. Therefore, whatever we speak, we do not speak anything which Krishna does not speak. That is our quality. And several times I was eulogized by many persons. I mean, you have done wonderful. So I say that I am not a wonderful man. I simply follow Krishna. What Krishna says, I repeat. Like parrot. That's all. I have no knowledge. But Krishna says that this is this, I accept it. And then that we shall be benefited. Just like a child, if he accepts the instruction of the parents, he gets knowledge. Parent will not cheat. If a child does not know a small word, he asks, father, what is it? Father can explain, my dear child, this is called what, you can see time, what is the time now? That is perfect knowledge. So that knowledge is perfect. Therefore, in the beginning of this chapter, and the fourth chapter, we said, evaṁ parampara prātam imaṁ rāja risayo vidu. If we get knowledge by the pure parampara system, pure disciplic succession, that knowledge is perfect. Then our life is perfect. And if we want to try to expound knowledge by our limited power, that is imperfect knowledge. That knowledge is not. That is concoction. If you want to take perfect knowledge, then you must get from the authorities. Evam parampara. That is Vedic knowledge. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva vigacchi samitpani sutriyam brahmanishtam. One must go to the guru. And who is guru? Guru sutriyam brahmanishtam. One who has heard from the parampara system and has become completely convinced in the understanding of Brahma. So, so this is the process. This humirapa, this material, it is not a fact. People are so much attached to this material world. That is called ignorance. Murha, they are called murha. Maya aparita jnana. Then knowledge has been taken away. It is these things will be explained in the latter verses. That do not try to take knowledge from imperfect person. Take knowledge from the perfect person, perfect Supreme Personality, who is perfect. God is perfect, and who carries the word of God, he is perfect. This is the definition of perfection. So Krishna says, Bhumi rāpo nalo vāyu. Matter is produced by Krishna's energy. It is not automatically produced. Just like I have given the example, that this body, this material gross body, is produced out of the soul which is put into the womb of the mother by the semina of the father. These descriptions are there in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, very nicely. You concern. So, that knowledge is perfect. Because, experimentally, science means observation and experiment. If you are observing something, then you must experiment. Jnanam vijnanam. In the previous verses, we have already studied that jnanam teham savijnanam. Jnanam teham sabhigan. Theoretical knowledge, that is observation. And sabhijnanam means experiment. If you say, if you have observed that life is produced of chemicals, then make experiment. Then it is science. Other it is hajpat. It has no meaning. Life is never produced of matter. Matter is produced out of life. We are fragmental matter, life. We living entity, small portion, very small portion. That is also given in the sastras. Kesagra satavagasya satadha kalpitasya. 1/10,000 part of the top of the hair. That is the magnitude of soul. Kesagra satavagasya satadha kalpitasya. Jiva bhava savigya. So anantaya kalpate. That jiva, ananta, unlimited. That is our magnitude. They cannot find out 1/10,000 part of the upper portion of the hair. There is no machine, no microscope. It's therefore, these foolish people, because they cannot see the dimension, length and breadth of the soul, they say the soul is nirakar. It is not nirakar. It has akar, but you cannot see with the blunt eye. Then how can I understand? Sotriyam brahmanistam tad vijnanartham sa guru meva vigat. You have to learn by hearing. There is no other process. The Veda says, the Shastra says, this is the magnitude of the soul, you have to take it. Then you will understand. Otherwise, by so-called experiment, you have neither instrument nor facility to make it. Find out. The first-class medical man or physiologist, find out where is the soul in this body. But they cannot. They have no such power. But there is something which being absent, the body is dead. That is a fact. That is a fact. Tathā dehāntaram prāpti. Then because that soul has gone out of this body, therefore the body is now dead. Therefore it is authority. What is the distinction between dead man and living man? That you have to understand. You cannot make experiment why the body is dead. But you can understand when you touch Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita says, Dehinasmin jatha dehi kaumaro jovanam jara tatha dehantara prati dhira sattana vayati. Dhira, those who are actually learned, sober, he is not agitated by the death of a man. Because he knows that the soul has now changed this body to another body. Just like he was changing from child's body to baby's body to boy's body to youth's body, from youth to old man's body. Now from this old man's body, now the body cannot be used. But I am saying, just like old garments, we give up and take another garment. Similarly, so long we are in the material world, we accept another material world. This is called transmigration of soul, death and birth. But when you are liberated from this conditioned life, you are fit for going to the spiritual world in your spiritual body. That is perfection of life. That is Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much.